G'day, Joey here. In our acoustic group, we've been doing this little classical piece called Minuet, Duet by a Johann Krieger. Here, let me put up the sheet we use. So you'll see it's meant to be a duet for two guitar parts for two peoples. If you can recall your old guitar lessons, you may have occasionally done stuff like this with your guitar teacher, where he or she would take one part and you take the other part and you'd swap and that sort of thing. So it's that sort of idea. But looking at it occurred to me a while back that this could be condensed into one guitar part, because indeed there's only one moment where the guitars cross over or play the same note. Otherwise, they're pretty much sticking to, bass strings for your thumb and higher strings for your fingers. So, as I always say, this sort of stuff is really good practice for fingerpicking acoustic blues type of guitar. I don't have a scientific evidence to prove that. It's just a personal opinion. But this is why I like this piece in particular. Because often your thumb's moving in one direction, your fingers are moving in another, and I reckon that's good practice. So let's have a go at it. And before I start, let me tell you one story about the time I did take acoustic blues guitar lessons, and it was for a small group. There were about six of us, and a guy dropped in on the second week, second night. He was a classical guitar player and he was sort of fiddling around before class, and then the teacher came in and asked him about it, and he could see, oh yeah, because he had his nylon string in, oh, you're a classical guitarist, all right, well, that's completely irrelevant, he said. And he sort of had a bit of a go at him, and needless to say, that bloke never turned up again to the remaining classes. And I always felt, even though, I enjoyed those lessons, but I always felt he was wrong about that. For me, any finger picking stuff is good practice for any finger picking stuff. That's my idea. So anything that exercises the fingers is going to help with your finger picking acoustic blues type of guitar. That's what I reckon. That's my personal opinion. And this is a great example. Let me go bar by bar. So I'll put four bars at a time up. So in total, there are 20 bars. Yeah, 20. The first eight bars are repeated, and then the second 12 bars are repeated, and that repeat includes actually the first eight bars, if that makes sense. You'll see when we get to it. So, and I'll just quickly go bar by bar just to show the fingering I use. There's your first bar, basically a bit of an A minor. Second bar. Note, using the thumb to get that low F. A classical guitarist would not do that, but I'm using a steel string. I'm practicing to keep my acoustic blues finger picking sharp, so I am going to use a thumb. So yes, use your thumb for this if that's what you're using this exercise for. And yeah, it works well, I reckon. So we've got. So that's basically a C. Next four bars. The ear, we've got a nice little bit. So when you do that C, you get a bit. Next part is basically an F chord. I would play like an F over C. In other words, keep your third finger on that C note. Use your little pinky to grab the F note, so that your third finger's still in that C, low C, and you can play it straight away, yeah? So, once again, from the C chord. Now, that is bar number six we're up to. That's an interesting part as well, because we're in A minor scale, but all of a sudden you're playing this, basically an E chord with a G sharp. Not only that, you go back to the C to finish off that bar number six. And what do we have here? C augmented, isn't that interesting? So augmented chords are one of those, that family of chords that are like an endless loop, that C augmented is the same as E augmented, is the same as G sharp augmented, or they all contain the same notes. That's the interesting thing about augmented chords. So that's a little curiosity that I find interesting. Of course, you get this sort of thing in other bits of music I've heard. The E major introduced into a scale that's basically A minor. For instance, that sort of Spanish sounding thing, yeah, flamenco. Obviously, I'm not a flamenco guitarist. That you get the E coming in at the end of that run of basically A minor scale chords. And what about Jimmy Page? Major. Similar thing happening. Yeah, anyway, sorry to go off track there. We're up to bar 7, so let's just do bar 6 again. And that ends that 8 bars that's repeated. Then we go to this nice little bit, so up to bar 9 there. So this is what I'm talking about. How notice how occasionally the fingers are doing a little run up or down, and then other parts like here we finish on this bar 16. You get the bass note, the bass strings doing a run down using your thumb. So once again, that's why I find it's really good practice. And then we're back to repeating those original 8 bars as part of this bunch of 12, and then that 12 gets repeated again. You go back to the... All right, let's play it all. And I'll have the metronome on my Guitar Pro at 96 beats per minute. I think that's a nice steady beat to do that at. Just let me set myself up and we'll record that.